This is another Out in the World edition.
Yeah, Out in the World.
$1 billion ambition.
Let's take it back to the era from 05 to 06 with Lil Wayne Carter 2 album, Jim Jones Hustler Poem album, and Jeezy's The Inspiration album. Around this time, 16 years ago, Lil Wayne dropped the Carter 2, which is the hottest thing on the streets, winter 2005.
Let's go. Cash money, young money, motherfuck the other side. They can fuck with us if they won't, I bring them homicide. Word to my mama, I'm gonna continue bombing. So like getting out the game, it's like coming out of a coma. I'm trying, but I'm normal when this rap shit get boring. All I ask is that you pray for me.
December 6, 2005, Lil Wayne released his fifth studio album, The Carter 2.
Yeah, hard body, hard body. Carter.
And opened up the album with the single Fireman. This is the album where he proved with his lyrical skills, with his quote saying that he's the best rapper alive. I've been a Wayne fan ever since I heard him on 400 Degrees in 98. And then in 99, he dropped his first album.
Lil Wayne dropped, came out with The Block Is Hot. That really gave me motivation to do it, cause he was young and successful making music.
That's what really motivated me. Like, he was a young nigga like me, I could relate. You know what I mean? He was lyrically just spitting that shit.
Don't hate on me, boy, if you just pack it down. Cover him under my shirt, try to lift you off the ground. But on the other hand, I'm a key runner, man. I got 100 coming up and 3 hummers, man. We stunners, man, I might stumble across the grand. Give it to your wifey and watch how she on my pipey like an icy.
2005, Wayne was at the top of his career. He was in the prime of his career. And he was definitely at it, and he became one of the elite.
Pistol lie inside of the armrest. Yes, lay a nigga down in his own mess. Don't mess, play a fuck around with the homeless. Charmless, you can leave out here armless, no homies.
In the new year of 2006, January 10th, he released the street banger, Hustler's Music, as a single and video.
Lil Wayne.
Hit me. Yeah. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. You already know. You already know. Now I want y'all to listen to me. Listen. I'm saying, make sure they hit me in the head with this one. I'ma paint the city red with this one. I'm
here with this one. See you rocking with the boy that told toys way before Christmas.
15 years ago, 2006, November, Jim Jones dropped the Hustler's Poem.
This what you wanted, right? You said you wanted the truth.
I remember this album specifically because during this time, this is when I turned blood. Now, I didn't turn blood because of these rappers was making blood famous. My neighborhood was blood. In 2000 and 2001, down south, when everybody was Crippin' Folk. I made a previous video about that. You wanna see the whole story? Check that one out.
This is my experience growing up in the blood neighborhood. First thing first, I gotta give you the history, the backdrop on the city. So at the time, like I'm telling you, Crip ran the city. Everybody wanted to be Crip. It was the popular thing, like how Bloods is now. But mind you, remember, we talking about the early 2000s. This is in the era of the West Coast dominating, Snoop Dogg. Everybody was Crip walking, Bow Wow. This is that time. So, you know, the whole blood should just coincide with the North side. It became identical, really. The East side nigga was Crip. North side, we blood. We already beef with every other side anyway.
I just turned 18 in October. I just banged home, got jumped in, put on a set in October. So that November, The Hustle's Poem, that was my soundtrack. You know, I remember around that time, me and the big homie at the time, Apollo, you guys went to a different hood and all that shit, but on the same side, the north side of the city. We went to Bradford Green and shit, pull up on the O-Lies out there to handle politics and get physical on the O-Lie tip. And I mean, we went over there and it was Billy's over there and they was bumping the Jim Jones album, specifically the Make It Rain song, the Weatherman with the India, Make It Rain. You know, at the beginning of the song, Jones be like, this is non-Trey.
This is non-Trey news.
So yeah, we was pulled up on the bellies, you know what I mean? Straightened out a situation. Went to a whole nother hood from Bradford Green, you know what I mean? Had to get physical with a nigga and duff him out, get him up out of here. But yeah, that album was definitely the soundtrack for that time. We was on Damu time. That's what was going on. We was in the projects every day, on the block every day. Now then, that winter, Jeezy drops the Inspiration.
Yes! It's real talk. Can I talk to y'all for a minute?
Yeah.
Up to the streets up there, had a homie come up to me, ask me, say, yo, everybody listening to you, everybody all ears.
Yeah.
What you gonna do to give back? I told him, look, homie, I'm 10 steps ahead of you, not 30.
Real talk,
listen up. Got one song, let's make it right.
When Jeezy drops the Inspiration, between The Hustle's Poem and The Inspiration, that was the first albums. I trapped my first pack on the block to that album, to those two albums.
In the era of the snowman, we was on the block trapping in the snow. Had the red gloves on my Damu time, you know what I mean? At the Bottom Hill store, getting them nicks off. Trapping, it's freezing like a motherfucker. It's wintertime.
Let's you know we trap all day, we play all night.
Oh.
This is the life of a
hey.
Go get her,
hey.
Go get her,
hey.
Go get her.
Jeezy had the appropriate name for that album too, The Inspiration. Because that's how niggas looked at Jeezy, especially at that time. Niggas was like, when I listen to Jeezy, Jeezy made me wanna go flip a brick, make me wanna go make money. Make me wanna go run it up.
Now I command you niggas to get money.
Hey.
Now I command you niggas to get money.
Hey.
Hence, Inspiration.
Somewhere in the back of my sick in the rain's brain, I get a rush when I talk that cane.
Hey.
Get money,
nigga, fuck them haters.
All we fear is the discovery
and indictment papers.
What's up?
Snowman, get your hands up high. It's your boy, Mr. 17-5. I take it back to the block, back to the kitchen, back to the pot. Snowman, get your hands up high.
Let's you know, we got Young Jeezy in here, everybody. 12-12, December 12th. The Inspiration comes out
this, I ain't gonna let him down on this one, man.
Yeah. So now,
I tried
the Inspiration, is it a continuance of you know, because certain people make certain records, like certain artists
yeah.
do, like this record, and then some make all that, like Busta Rhymes, all stuff goes through. I don't know if yours gonna continue, like this is the.
I mean, it's gonna pretty much continue the same, you know, the same pace of things. I grew a little bit. I'm quite sure everybody else did with me, but you know, Inspiration, it came from, like, you know, just being out in the streets and cats running up on you, like, yo, man. Just keep what you're doing, you know, doing what you're doing for us. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? When you get people through their day, you touch the hearts of men, and that's inspiration. Mm-hmm. They inspire me to inspire them, you know what mm-hmm. I mean? So when I go in the booth, I go harder for them. I think I went a little harder on this album than I did the last mm-hmm. because I understand it now, how powerful words are mm-hmm. and how, you know, how the homies just be like, okay, you know, he's speaking for us. You know, mm-hmm. some things ain't for everybody, but I know who my music is for, you know what I mean? Yeah, okay. And I know the type of cats that respect my music, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So well, that song, that's what I'm on.
Well, yeah. Yo, Jeezy, I want to take you back to this I Love It song. I got to tell you, the first time I heard it,
yeah.
I was happy to hear you. I was like, oh, man, my man's back. Let me see what he got. Let me see
yeah,
what he got.
Yeah,
you
know yeah, yeah.
The first time you get your ears on it, right? So there's the beginning verse, you say something real crazy about time.
Yeah.
I threw it back to the verse, but you said something that really touched me. It was boom. I said,
like, you know, check your watch, homie. It's my time. You know, in that case, time waits for no man.
That was deep.
Check your watch, yeah, it's my time. Mind made up, I was on my grind. So pay attention, yeah, you own my time. In that case, time waits for no man. Do it again, I'm done it before, man. M-O-E. Hey, my baby, little boys ain't listening. Open your eyes. We got hundreds on the table, 20s on the floor. Fresh out of work. And I love it, hey. And I love it. Hands up, I got gangsters in the crowd, bad problems in my show. Shit parked outside, sitting on the floor. And I love it.
$1 billion ambition. It's the mind frame. The dedicated drive that's designed to breed progress.
Oh, sick. Picture me rolling like Pac in the 90s, ho. Knocked off that 50 pack, told him bring me my 90 mo. Already famous, I was a star at the corner store.